ओम वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसम प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदं। वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। अल्पाक्षरम् असन्दिग्धम्
अल्पाक्षरम् असन्दिग्धम्
सारवत् विश्वतो मुखम् अस्तोभम् अनवद्यं च सूत्रं सूत्रविदो विदुः खपचटतौ कपै शशसर इति माहेश्वराणि सूत्राणि अक्कुविसर्जनीयानां कण्ठः इचुयशानां तालु रुटुरशानां मूर्धा लुतुलसानां दन्ताः उपोपद्मानीयानां ओष्टौ ज्ञामाङ्गाढनां नासिका च एदैतोः कण्ठतालु ओदौ तोगो कंट कंट ओष्टम अकारस्य दंत ओष्टम जिह्वा मूलीयस्य जिह्वा मूल्यम नासिका अनुस्वारस्य रामो राजमनिः सदा विजयते रामं रमेशं भजे रामेणाभिहता निशाचरचमूः रामाय तस्मै नमः रामान्नास्ति परायणं परतरम् रामस्य दासोऽस्म्यहम् रामे चित्तलयः सदा भवतु मे भो राममामुद्धर Let's we chanted Rama Shabda. Now, today we will chant Strilinga Saranama Shabda. Takarantaha Strilingaha Tad Shabdaha.
Takarantaha Strilingaha Shabdaha.
Satetaha.
Satetaha.
Tamtetaha. तयाताभ्यां ताभिः तस्यैताभ्यां ताभ्यः तस्याः ताभ्यां ताभ्यः तस्याः तयोः तासाम् तस्यां तयोः तासु
तस्यां तयोः तासु
तकारान्तः श्रीलिङ्गः एतद् शब्दः
तकारान्तः श्रीलिङ्गः एतद् शब्दः
एषा एते एताः एताम् एनाम् एते एने एताः एनाः एतया एनया एताभ्याम् एताभिः एतस्यै एताभ्याम् एताभ्यः एतस्याः एताभ्याम् एताभ्यः एतस्याः एतयोः एनयोः एतासाम् एतस्याम् एतयोः एनयोः एतासु
एतस्याम् एतयोः एनयोः एतासु
अकारान्तः स्त्रीलिङ्गः किं शब्दः
अकारान्तः स्त्रीलिङ्गः किं शब्दः
आदेशः काम के काह कया काभ्याम काभिहि तस्यै काभ्याम काभ्यः कस्याः काभ्याम काभ्यः कस्याः कयोः कासाम् कस्याम् कयोः कासु तकारान्तः स्त्रीलिङ्गः यत् यत् शब्दः
स्त्रीलिङ्गः
यां येयाः यया याभ्यां याभिः यस्यै याभ्यां याभ्यः यस्याः याभ्यां याभ्यः यस्याः ययोः यासाम् यस्यां ययोः यासु पुंसकलिङ्ग आल्सो विवचन दकारान्तः नपुंसकलिङ्गः तत् शब्दः तत्तेतानि तत्तेतानि तेन ताभ्यां तैः तस्मै ताभ्यां तेभ्यः तस्मात् ताभ्यां तेभ्यः तस्य तयोः तेषाम् अस्मिन् तयोः तेषु तकारान्तः नपुंसकलिङ्गः एतत् शब्दः एतत् एते एतानि एतत् एनत् एते एने एतानि एनानि एतेन येनेन एताभ्याम् एतैः एतस्मै एताभ्याम् एतेभ्यः एतस्मात् एताभ्याम् एतेभ्यः एतस्य एतयोः एनयोः एतेषाम् एतस्मिन् एतयोः एनयोः एतेषु अकारान्त अन्तः नपुंसकलिङ्गः किं शब्दः You all can hear me, right?
Yes,
sir. Yes,
Guruji. Girija, you have a problem.
Yeah, audible nowadays.
Your voice is not audible. Anyway, others, is my voice audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Guruji.
Yes, Guruji. Yes, now I got it. Thank you.
Yeah, I think your side problem.
Yeah, I had some problem, so I changed the instrument.
It's improved a lot.
Kim ke kaani?
Kim ke kaani?
Kim ke kaani?
Kim ke kaani?
Kena kabhyam kaihi?
Kena kabhyam kaihi?
Asmai kabhyam kebhyah? कस्मात् काव्यं केभ्यः
कस्मात् काव्यं केभ्यः
तस्य तयोः केषां
तस्य तयोः केषां
कस्मिन् तयोः केषु
कस्मिन् तयोः केषु
कारान्तः नपुंसकलिङ्गः यत् शब्दः
तकारान्तः
नपुंसकलिङ्गः यत् शब्दः
यत् येयानि
यत् येयानि
यत् येयानि
यत् येयानि
येन याभ्यां यैः
येन याभ्यां यैः
यस्मै याभ्यां येभ्यः
यस्मात्
याभ्यां येभ्यः यस्य ययोः येषां यस्मिन् ययोः येषु All the shabdas, we have taught you, we chanted before. This is only the revision. So you, after the shabda, you must be knowing. Now, please type your name in the chat box. We'll continue the Sandhi exercise after this exercise. Okay. Now, this is to test your shabda. Please type your name in the chat box. And if we can type. Okay. Now, identify the cases. I'll call the name, then you can unmute the mic. Others, now we can mute. Pashupatina, Tritiya Vibhakti Ekavachana. And Pratipadika is Pashupati. Hari Shabdavati, Ikaranta Shabda. Harina, Pashupatina. Similarly, the other words you have to find out what Vibhakti and what is the Pratipadika. Okay. Pramila, starting from you. Each one of you can do three. Yes, Pramila, you can start. Unmute your mic.
Ji.
Yes.
Balan. Akarantaha Pullingaha Bala Shabdaha Akarantaha Pullingaha Dutiya Vibhakti Ekavachanam.
Dutiya Vibhakti. What Vachanam?
Oh, Bahuvachanam Ji.
Bahuvachanam. Balan, okay. Tebhyaha.
Tatshabdam. Tatshabdam. Trishulingeshu.
Not Trishulingeshu. Why Trishulingeshu?
Oh, this is Saha. Ji, Saha. उपुलिंगम तच्छब्दम पुल्लिंगम जी
not only pullinga even napumsakalinga from tritiya vibhakti onwards same as pullinga only
yes sir chaturthi vibhakti panchami vibhakti bahuvachanam
yes chaturthi bahuvachana panchami bahuvachanam for pullinga as well as strilinga tat shabda it can be anything
pakash
but not the strilinga strilinga will be what is the form for strilinga ताभ्यः ताभ्यः इट इज डिफरेंट यस नेक्स्ट वन पाकशालाया
पाकशाला शब्दं स्त्रीलिंगं आकारान्तः स्त्रीलिंगं पाकशालायां षष्ठी विभक्ति बहुवचनम्
रियली थिंक इज अ षष्ठी विभक्ति
जी 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 सप्तमी विभक्ति एकवचनम् सॉरी
सप्तमी एकवचनम् नेक्स्ट पर्सन गिरिजा जी
यस गुरु जी पूजा गृहम इज नपुंसकलिंगम इट कैन बी एकवचनम और आई मीन प्रथम विभक्ति द्वितीय विभक्ति बोथ आर पूजा गृहम एंड दंडे दंडा इज द प्रातिपदिकम दंडेन हस्तेन दंडेन तृतीय विभक्ति एकवचनम
रियली तृतीय विभक्ति
दंडे दंडे सप्तमी सॉरी सप्तमी विभक्ति एकवचनम
व्हाट लिंग इज दैट
दंडः इज पुल्लिंगः
पुल्लिंग The next one.
Bhima Bhyam is Bhima Bhyam is Saptami Vibhakti Ekavachanam. Bhimaha.
Think.
Bhima.
Saptami.
Bhima Bhyam. Yes, Guruji.
Saptami.
Ramayam. Saptami Ekavachanam. Bhima. depending on the context one of them will apply if it is with by bhima it will be tritiya if it
it's
is
okay,
for
okay.
bhima
not like that it is not by for and all that we will see later I have not talked like that I never thought karaka I mean I got only prathama vibhakti and ditya vibhakti tritiya onwards okay. I have not thought so it is okay. not by it is not for if that orientation is there it will create problem later when we do translation no it is not like that you always have to ask question and get answer it is not strictly the prepositional meaning with the prepositional meaning only but not with the english preposition strictly if that understanding is there it will create problem so please
okay Guruji
That I'll talk about karaka slowly. Then we'll see that all the karakas are introduced. Okay. I thought there is a shabda chanting every class we are chanting. Is it sometimes I think it's waste of time. No, it is not waste of time because when I see that when you answer correctly, then only I'll get the confidence. Yes. But still the confusion is there bhima abhyam and similarly pakashalayam I think it is worth chanting every class revising all the shabdas at least one or two shabdas but you please chant it every day make it as your daily routine
yes Guruji
just merely chanting you have to commit this to all the shabdas to memory important Surendran ji next one it's a three
vidyayoho Like Saptami too, like Rama Shabda, Ramayohu.
Oh, really? Okay. Well, what's the Pratipadika? Vidya? Is there any word Vidya? Akarantaha, Pullingaha, Vidya Shabdaha. What does it mean, Vidya means? What is the meaning of Vidya?
Vidya, 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 Vidya. Sorry, Vidya.
Vidya.
Vidya, Vidya. Striling, Striling, Vidya Shabda.
You will answer, okay. Swendriji.
Vidya Shabda.
Not Vidya, there is no word Vidya, no Kalpana. What is there? If it is Vidyaya, then it will not be Vidya Yoga. It will be Vidyaya Yoga, it will be. That is also not correct. Pratipadigam is Vidya Yoga is there. It is like Ramashabda, Akarantaha, Strilingaha. Ramashabdaha, Ramayoga.
30 second.
That's okay. That will come later. First, you have to tell the Pratipadika. Pratipadika, it's a problem. Then how do you know Vidya, what Vibhakti is?
Vidya, Vidya.
Not Vidya. Where is Vidya? We are talking...
Vidya, Vidya. Vidya.
Vidya. No practice. That's a problem. No, have you ever chanted it? Do you chant Shabda daily, Surendraji?
Yeah, I do.
You have to chant Shabda. When I give a word, you have to identify what Vibhakti, what Vachana. That is language part also important. One is grammar part, other one is language part. So we have to balance both. That's why I thought today we can take up this at first and do. Vidya Yoga, like Rama Shabda, Akaranta, Srilinga, Rama Yoga, Vidya Yoga. What Vibhakti, what Vachana?
Shasti second, no, Vidya Yoga.
Is it there only in Shasti Vibhakti?
That Saptami also you can have second.
Not you can have, it is also there. So you have to tell both. It is Shasti Dvivachanam, Saptami Dvivachanam. Next one, continue.
Adhyapakaha.
No, read that properly. It is not Adhyapaka.
Adhyapikaha.
Adhyapaka is Pullinga.
Adhyapikaha. Adhyapikaha. Srilinga Pradama Vibhakti 3, 1, 3.
Is it only 1, 3? Is it not there any other place? Think.
Tritiya also can come.
Really? Tell me what is the Tritiya form?
Ramaha.
We are bringing Rama here. Rama, let Rama be aside.
Ramaha, it can come. Tritiya. Second, 2, 3.
Very good, 2, 3. Is it there only in 2, 3? 1, 3 and 2, 3 only?
And 3, 3 also.
Really? Tell me what is 3, 3?
Ramaya, Ramabhyam.
Again, Ramaha.
Only two.
No. Only another place also is there. Can anybody say where it is?
Sambodhana.
Very good.
Sambodhana.
Sambodhana also it is there. Hey Rame, hey Ramaha. It is 1, 3, 2, 3, and as well as 8, 3. Okay, next one, continue.
Chandrikaya.
Not Gaya, nothing Gaya, it is Chandrikaya.
Chandrikaya, 1, 1.
1, 1. Oh, what does it mean, Chandrikaya? How do you declare Chandrikaya, Chandrikaya, Chandrikaya? It should have some meaning, right? What is Chandrikaya?
Oh, it will be 3, 1 then, correct?
3, 1. Chandrika means the rays of the moon. Chandrasya, that Reshmi.
3, 1 it is.
Jyotsna is called Chandrika. Tritiya Vibhakti Ekavachanam. Next person, Kausalyaji. Next 3.
Nasikaya. Tritiya Ekavachanam. Nasikaya.
Pratipadikam.
Nasika.
Yes.
Okay, continue. Atithi bihi, pratipadikam as atithi, tritiya bahuvachana, atithi bihi.
Yes, atithi, atithi, atithayaha, okay, yes, right.
Then shishu bihi, Shishu is the Pratipadikam. Shishu Bihi is...
Shishu Bihi only, not yeah. Shishu.
Sorry. Shishu Bihi. Tritiya Bahuvachanam.
Yes, Tritiya Bahuvachanam. Shishu Karanta Pratipadikam. Next person, Tanujaji.
Hari. Tantu Bihi. Tantu is the Pratipadikam. This is the Tritiya Vibhakti Bahuvachanam.
Good.
Tantu Bihi. Taya Tachaptaha Strilingaha. Vimale is Strilinga Shabdaha Vimala Rama Rame Vimale. So 1, 2 and also 2, 2 and Saptami also. Sambodhana. Eighth case Bahuvachan.
Not Bahuvachan.
Ekvachanam. Yeah.
As well as Dvivachanam. Both.
Yeah. Yes.
So in four places it is Vimale. Depending on the context, we have to take what it is, what meaning is. Okay, next person. Lataji.
Yes, sir. Chatraihi. Chatra Pratipadikam Chatraha. Dvitiya Vibhakti.
Chatra is the Pratipadikam, not Chatraha.
Chatra Pratipadikam. Dvitiya Vibhakti Bahuvachana. Chatrahi.
Okay.
Bhojanam. Pratipadikam.
Bhojana is a Pratipadikam, not Bhojanam.
Bhojana Pratipadikam.
Okay, Bhojanam then become Akaranta. It is not Makaranta. Akarantaha Napumsakalingaha Bhojana Shabdaha.
Bhojana Pratipadikam. Panchami Vibhakti Ekavachana. Correct,
yes, yes. Please continue. Correct.
Kagaha Pratipadikam. Ekavachanam Bahuvachanam.
Prathamavibhakti
Bahuvachanam.
Okay.
Guruji, one thing. Chatrai is the third, which case she said? Sorry, I missed on that. Chatraihi, that's the third case.
That's what she said. Tritiya.
Okay. Tritiya Bahuvachanam.
Bahuvachanam.
Okay.
Next person. Jyoti ji.
Pachakaihi. Pachaka Shabda. Tritiya Bahuvachanam. Mitrani Mitra Shabda. Prathama Dvitiya Bahuvachanam.
Also Sambodhana.
Sambodhana. Yes, Guruji.
Sambodhana also.
Mani Bhihi.
Already have given this
that. Mani Shabda. Tritiya Bahuvachanam.
Ekavachanam. Okay, Bahuvachanam. By mistake, I given Ekavachanam. It is maybe he is Bahuvachanam. Okay. Next person, Krishna Kumar.
Okay, ji. Kusumaihi. Kusuma Shabdaha. It's like Ram. Rama Shabdaha. Strilingam.
Rama Shabda. Rama Shabda, where which Vibhakti, what Vibhakti, what Vachanam? It's like Rama Shabda.
Rama Shabda. No, it's not coming in Rama Shabda. It's it should be Strilingam, like Rama Shabda.
Rama Shabda is Pullinga, not Strilinga.
Sorry, Pullinga.
Then if Ramayi. It is... Ramehi. So Pratipadikam is
Karena Ramena. Sorry, yes, Kusumehi. Kusuma. Kusuma is a Pratipadikam.
Kusuma is a Pratipadikam. It is
Tritiya Vibhakti Bahuvachanam.
Tritiya Vibhakti Bahuvachanam. But it is not Pullinga, it is Napumsakalinga.
Okay.
forms are same, both for Napumsakalinga and Pullinga. Tritiya Vibhakti onwards, same he said for Akaranta, right? Akaranta Shabda, Pala Shabda, what we chanted before.
Yes,
Nama Shabda, Tritiya Vibhakti onwards, same. Therefore, Kusuma is a Pratipadikam, Napumsakalinga, Kusumaihi. Pulling, it is not pulling a shabda. The shabda, when you know the shabda, you have to know the meaning as well as the gender. Kusuma meaning flower, it is napumsakalinga.
Okay.
Next one, continue.
Karena, it is also like Rama Shabda, Ramena. It is Tritiya Vibhakti, Ekavachanam.
Yes.
And the Pratipadikam is Kara.
Kara. Kara means hand.
Hand.
Hasta. Okay.
And third one, Lekanya, Lekana Shabdaha.
Lekana, okay. If it is Lekana, can you chant where you Lekanya is there?
Lekanya, sorry, Guruji, I'm unable to get that.
All the forms already, already learnt Shabda only. I'm not given anything which we don't know. So, Lekanya. This that the Sanskrit about the Rashtri Sanskrit Samstan, that words also we have seen Lekani, Ankani, and all this vocabulary also we have seen Lekani, Ikarantaha, Nadi Shabdavat, Nadi Nadyo Nadyaha. Do you know Nadi Shabda?
Nadi Shabda, yeah. Yeah, I've seen it, but I forgot actually.
Please chant all the Shabda every day. It will not take more than 15 minutes. At least, if not all the Shabda, one Shabda a day. Commit this Shabda to memory. By seeing the form, you should be able to say the Vibhakti and the Pratipadikam. Vibhakti, first you have to identify the Vibhakti and the Pratipadikam. Lekanya, like Nadi Shabda, Nadya, Tritiya Vibhakti, Ekvacham. It is not Akaranta Shrilinga. It is Ikaranta Shrilinga. Lekanya 3-1. Next person, Rajeshwarji.
Amba, Strilinga, Amba Shabdaha, Prathama Vibhakti Ekvachan. Dhanikebhyaha.
Ekavachanam.
Ekavachanam.
Ekvachan, Ekvachan is Hindi.
Sorry, Ekvachanam. Dhanikebhyaha. Pullingaha, Dhanik Shabdaha. Chaturthi Panchami Bahuvachan.
Chaturthi Vibhakti Bahuvachanam Panchami Bahuvachanam.
Bahuvachan. Chaturthi Vibhakti Bahuvachanam Panchami Vibhakti Bahuvachanam. Sambhashane. Pullingaha Sambhashana Shabdaha Saptami Vibhakti Ekavachanam.
Really? Sambhashana is Pullinga.
Sambhashana. It's a Striling? No, Sambhashanam. So maybe Napusakling?
It should be Napumsakalinga, not Napumsakalinga. Napumsakalinga. Sambhashana Shabdaha. Napumsakalingaha.
Sambhashana Shabdaha. Napusakling. Then also
Napumsakalingaha.
Napusaklingaha.
Not Napumsak. Napumsakalingaha.
Napumsakalingaha. Sorry. Okay. And also, this is Saptami.
Our class is 94th class. I should know all those things by this time. Okay.
Sorry. Saptami Vibhakti Ekavachanam.
Is it only in Saptami Vibhakti Ekavachanam?
Dvitiya and Tritiya Vibhakti Dvivachanam?
Tritiya Dvivachanam. Where it is, sir?
Dvitiya, Pratama Dvitiya.
Pratama Vibhakti Dvivachanam, Dvitiya Vibhakti
Dvivachanam.
And?
And also
Saptami Ekavachanam. Sambodhanam also it is.
Sambodhanam also Dvivachanam.
Dvivachanam. In four places the word Sambhashane is. Sambhashana, Palashabdavat, Palampale Palani, Palampale Palani. Then Saptami is Pale, Pale Palayoho Paleshu. And Sambodhana, Hepale.
Hepale.
Hepalani. Places it is there.
Yes.
Okay, the next person, Anuradha ji.
Yes, Sharan ji. Tasam is tad shabdah. It is shashti tritiya. And yes. Nakshatreshu is nakshatra shabdam.
Shashti vibhakti bahu vachanam.
Bahu, yeah, sorry, bahu vachanam. And nakshatreshu is nakshatra shabdah, shabdam. And it is
shabdaha, it is what linga?
Shabdaha is pullinga.
Shabdaha is pullinga. Nakshatra what shabda?
That is napumsakalinga.
Napumsakalinga.
Nakshatra. Yeah. And then nakshatreshu is seventh saptami and bahuvachanam.
Ekavachanam.
Nakshatreshu.
Sorry, it's okay. Bahuvachanam, fine.
Bahuvachanam. Then patrikanam.
Patrikanam.
Patrikanam. Patrikanam. So it is patrika shabdam. And patrikanam, just mention patrika
akaranta, ramash, yes, ramashabda.
Yeah, so then it should be shashti vibhakti bahuvachanam.
Good. Next person, others also can type the name. This is a simple exercise, already we have learnt nothing new in this. Okay. See, if you participate in the class, you will learn. I will ask question. Definitely, I will ask question. If you tell wrongly, definitely, I will ask question. I'll make you say the right answer. That is how learning happens. If you don't type, if you be a mute spectator, I don't know whether you really understand. Okay, anyway, your choice. Pramilaji, back to you.
The consequences also. Udhyana.
Is some noise is there. Somebody news also, apparently. See, when you unmute, to make sure that there is, the noise is not the background. Yeah. Yes, yes, read.
Udhyana. Udhyanam. शब्दः उद्यान शब्दः अकारान्तः नपुंसकलिङ्गः पञ्चमी विभक्ति एकवचनम्
यस्
प्रवेशः प्रवेश शब्दं प्रवेश शब्दं अकारान्तः
शब्दः
शब्दः अकारान्तः पुल्लिङ्गः प्रवेशः
प्रवेश शब्दः प्रथमा विभक्ति
प्रवेश शब्दः अकारान्तः पुल्लिङ्गः प्रथमा विभक्ति एकवचनम्
ओके
अज्ञानाम्
रीड दैट प्रॉपर्ली
अज्ञानानाम्
यस
अज्ञान शब्दः अकारान्तः पुल्लिङ्गः
Ajnanam, we have used so many times in the Vedanta class also. Ajnanam, jnanam, ajnanam. It is not pullinga.
Okay, it is napumsakalinga.
Napumsakalinga, yes. Aam is there. So, aam, ajnananam, ramanam, palanam.
Chi. Shashti Vibhakti Bahuvachanam.
Shashti Vibhakti Bahuvachanam. Next person, Girijaji.
Yes, Guruji. Vishvasya. Vishvasya is like Ramasya, Shashti Vibhakti, Ekavachanam. And Vishvam, I think, is Napunsakalinga, Guruji.
Vishva is Sarvanama Shabda also is there. And as a universe, it is pulling also. So it's okay.
Okay. Dvichakra Vichakra Bhyam.
Okay.
This is Dvichakrika. Is the
it must be Dvichakrika. It's a typo.
Dvichakrika, yeah. Strilinga padam, and it is Chaturthi and Panchami Dvivachana.
Yes.
Kutilan, Kutilaha, Kutila is the Pratipadikam. Kutilan is the Dvivachanam. Dvitiya Vibhakti, Bahuvachanam.
Yes. Next person. Surendra.
Yuva Kebhyaha Chaturthi Vibhakti 3.
Chaturthi Vibhakti. Why not Panchami also?
Panchami.
Panchami also. Chaturthi and Panchami Bhagavachana. Pratipadikam is?
Yuvaka.
Yuvaka. Okay. Continue.
Second is Vritta. One.
Yes. Akaranta Srilinga Shabda Vritta. Okay.
Vritta. Avakashayohu. Avakashayohu. Shasti. Vibhajanam.
As well as Saptami Dvivachanam. Shashti, yeah, and Saptami Dvivachanam. Okay, next person. Kausalyaji.
Ari Bihi. Pratipadikam is Ari. Tritiya Bahuvachanam.
Okay.
Te Tadshabdaha. Strilingaha. Prathama Dvivachanam and Dvitiya.
Strilinga, Dvitiya.
Dvitiya Prathama Vibhakti and Dvitiya Dvivachanam. And even Napumsaka Lingaha. Prathama Vibhakti Dvivachanam and Dvitiya Vibhakti.
What about Sambodhana for Srilinga?
Sambodhana also. Sambodhana.
Sambodhana not there. Tatshabda where is Sambodhana?
Okay. Sarvanama Shabda.
Tricky yeah. Question. Okay. It's not there. Sambodhana not there for, right?
Okay.
So, Srilinga is 1-2 and 2-2. Prathama Vibhakti Dvivachanam and Dvitiya Vibhakti Dvivachanam. Napumsakalinga also Prathama Vibhakti Dvivachanam. Dvitiya Vibhakti Dvivachanam. What about Pullinga?
Bahuvachanam, Prathama Vibhakti.
Prathama Vibhakti? Prathama Vibhakti, Bahuvachanam, right? Is it there only that te only, is there? There are no other te? Anybody can answer, open to all. Where else te is there? What are the te you remember? Anybody, yeah, please answer.
Yeah, that is all.
That's all, really.
Tattetani.
Tattetani, she said. Tattetani, tattetani. Then satetaha, satetaha. Sagataute, sagataute.
Even dvitiya dvivachanam.
Huh?
Dvitiya dvivachanam also.
Where? All the six places she has said already. Napumsakalinga, Prathama Vibhakti Dvivachanam, Dvitiya Vibhakti Dvivachanam, she said.
Similarly, five places. Five places only, Lanji.
Five places.
Sambodhana.
Sambodhana is not there.
Sambodhana not. Five places. Pullinga one place and
Strilinga two.
Strilinga two places. Napumsakalinga two. Places. Five places. I'm asking some more places also. It is there. Where are they? Huh?
Clue.
Okay. Yushmat Shabda.
Three. Yushmat Shabda.
Vishmat Shabda, Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam. We know that. Do we know or not?
Chaturthi, Shashti.
There also te is there. There the meaning is different. The Shabda is Takarantaha Yushmat Shabda. Okay, let us chant that. I think you have forgotten this. You have to chant every day, then only you will remember, otherwise you will not remember. So where is te?
I am not chanting that te, so I can't remember. I used to chant only tubhyam and tava.
They also eat is there. Te or te namaha. Namaste, we say. Every class begin with namaste. Namaha te. Te is there. We don't say tava te, tubhyam te. Namaste, namaha te. Tubhyam namaha, te namaha. So te is there also. Okay. This is important shabda. Asmad and Nishmad. So if you ask te means you are doing all the te. Many places are it is there. Anyway, it's okay. Okay, we will chant the Shabda next class. We'll continue. The next one. This is your homework. I will send you this. You write this. Okay. Now we will continue with the Sandhi exercise. Hope you can recall the Sandhi what we saw. Shtutva Sandhi. Shtutva Sandhi we have seen. And Shtutva Sandhi now. Shtutva Sandhi, you remember what is the exception for Shtutva? One exception is among the eight possibility, some possibility is not there. And one exception, possibility is not there, that limit, not no problem.
Ish plus tu is exception.
No, tu is preceded by Shakara. Then Shtutvam won't happen.
That is all you have to say. Tu is preceded by Shakara.
Is preceded by Shakara.
Not Ashtara. Ish. Don't say ish plus tu. No. That e also is not correct. It is Shakara only. You have to say Shakara. Not ish.
So we should say as tu preceded by is. Sorry. Tu preceded by ish.
Not ish. The ish is wrong. Wrong we are saying ish.
Shakara, Shakara, Shakara. Sorry.
When you say ish, you are adding bubble to it. You have to say Shakara only. Tavarga preceded by Shakara. Shtutvam will not happen. That is Apavada. Then in Shtutva Sandhi also, that we have seen, two Apavadas are there that we are going to see. Shtutva Sandhi, we know. What does it say, Shtutva? Tavarga or Sakara in contact with Murdhanya Shakara or Tavarga. And the contact will be preceding or succeeding. Then what will happen? Sakara will be replaced by Murdhanya Shakara. And Tavarga will be replaced by corresponding Shavarga letter. Right? We know this. Exception I will teach today. The last class we have seen this. When Stu is in contact with Shtu, what does it mean? Can anyone say? When Stu is in contact with Shtu, it means?
When Sakara or Tu is in contact with Shakara or Tu.
Tavarga.
What type of contacts possible?
Either preceding or succeeding.
Either preceding or succeeding.
So, how many possibilities you will have?
Four.
Eight.
Okay. Eight.
For eight possibilities.
Eight possibilities.
For each, there are four possibilities. And Sakara and two are there. Therefore, eight possibilities. And Sakara, it is fourth possibility for each, it's four possibility. It can be following, that is, Shakara can and Tavarga can be following or can be preceding also. Therefore, for Sakara, four possibility. For Tavarga, four possibility. So, four plus four, eight possibilities are there. And some possibilities not there, in fact, because examples not there, such context not there, that leave it, no problem. But there are some exceptions that we have to know, right? So, when Stu is in contact with Shtu, Stu will be replaced by Shtu. That is, Sakara in contact with Murdhanya Shakara, whether preceding or succeeding. Sakara in contact with Tavarga, whether preceding or succeeding. Sakara will be replaced by Murdhanya Shakara. Then Tavarga in contact with Shakara or Tavarga, whether preceding or succeeding, Tavarga will be replaced by corresponding Tavarga letter. This is the rule. Is the rule clear?
Yes, Guruji.
Yes, now we will see the exception. First, we will learn the exception. There are three exceptions. Actually, two exceptions. The third exception is exception to the exception. Therefore, it will fall into the main rule. So, exception number one. When tavarga is followed by shakara, that is succeeding context, then shtuttvam will not happen. When tavarga is followed by, is in contact with shakara, and the shakara follows, then shtuttvam will not happen. Example, bhavan plus shashtaha. Here, which is a tavarga letter?
Not able to see.
Nakara.
Not able to?
You need to scroll, G.
It is clear, it is there. I can see. My cursor is there, shows. It is highlighted now. Can you see all of you? Must
we
see?
Yeah, we can see.
Yes,
yes, Guruji.
We can see.
Bhavan plus Shashtaha. Nakara is there. Nakara is a tavarga letter, which is in contact with, and the contact is following contact with shakara. Then in that case, shtuttam will not happen. If shtuttam would have happened, what would have happened? Nakara will be replaced by
tavarga.
Anunasika of tavarga letter. That doesn't happen. So you need to know this exception. So when you do Shtutta Sandhi, you have to see. First exception you have to see. If exception is that, don't apply. Okay. Immediately don't apply Shtutta Sandhi. When Tavarga and Tavarga is there, no. You have to see the exception. First apply the exception. See whether it falls within the scope of exception. If it is not, then you apply the Utsarga, the general rule. The general rule is Shtutva. So here it is not applied. This is exception number one. Is it clear? Exception.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Guruji.
Next one. Exception number two now. Here it says, when stu means sakara and tavarga. When stu is preceded by, now you see preceding contact, preceded by padanta tu, preceded by tu. When stu is preceded by tu, and what tu is that? Padanta tu. What is a padam? Sukting, subanta, tinganta is a padam. Okay. The padam, all the shabdas what you declined, is a padam. The kriya padam, padam. So, if takara at the end of the padam, and the takara means tavarga, not takara. Tavarga. Takara also is that tavarga. And tavarga at the end of the padam precedes stu. Stu means sakara or tavarga. Then stuttam will not happen. Example, Virat plus Tapati. Virat is Ishvara. Virat. The total. Virat Tapati. Does tapas. Virat is Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachana. It is Virat. It is Shabda. Tapati is there. Now, Tapati, Takara is there. The first letter, Takara. It is in contact with Takara, which is Tavarga letter. What contact? Preceding contact. And what Takara? Padanta Takara. Virat is a Padam. Only when it is a Padam. Remember, only when it is a Padanta Tavarga, then only Shtuttam will not happen. If it is not Padam, if it is Apadanta, that is, tavarga not at the end of the padam, then shtuttam will happen. You have to understand the exception very clearly. When stu is preceded by padanta tu, if it is apadanta tu, shtuttam will happen. If it is padanta tu, then shtuttam will not happen. Exception. Therefore, virat is a padam. Therefore, virat takara at the end of the padam, with which the takara is in contact. Therefore, shtuttam will not apply virat tapati. You understand this exception number two?
Yes, Guruji.
If it is apadanta too, remember stuttam will happen. Therefore, when you do sandhi, you have to see whether it is padam or not. But its condition also important. When do you see that condition? When tavarga, when stu. Not only tavarga, stu. When stu is preceded by tavarga, you have to watch this. Whether the tavarga letter at the end is a, it's a padanta tavarga or not. If it is so, then don't apply stuttvam. Exception. Okay. The next exception, exception number 3. That is exception to exception number 2. That is exception to exception number 2. What is that? We will see. For that, we should know what exception number 2. That we know. Exception 2 is stu in contact with padanta to preceding contact, then stuttam will not happen. Now you see this. When, this is very particular to few shabda. 3 shabdas only. Not much important. When nam, navati, nagari. These are the 3 the words. Nam, navati, nagari. All the 3 words you can see, they beginning with tavarga letter. Nam is nakara, navati also beginning with nakara, nagari also. The 3 words beginning with nakara. When this is preceded by padanta 2. When this is preceded by padanta 2, then what will happen? Then stuttam will happen. And what did we say in exception 2? When stu is preceded by padanta 2, stuttam will not happen, we said. But now here we say, for these 3 words alone, for these 3 words alone, which beginning with tavarga letter, that is nakara, particularly nakara, when this is preceded by, these are preceded by the padam, padanta 2, then stuttam will happen. Therefore, this is
except. The meaning of the word navati? The meaning of the word navati?
Don't worry about that, leave it. These are 3 words are there. We will see that navati is 90, nagari is a city, nam is a pratyaya. Okay, that is not important. Just know these 3 words. This is exception only for 3. Okay. When these 3 words are preceded by padanta 2, then stuttam will happen. When stuttam will happen means it will fall into the main rule. The main rule is stutta rule. That is a rule. Stu is for contact with stu. Stuttam will happen. So that is why I said exception to exception number 2. So therefore, it will fall into the main category. Example, you can see. Shan plus nam. Shan is number 6. Nam is a pratyaya. That's why I said don't worry about it. Nam is a pratyaya. Shashti vibhakti bhaguvachana pratyaya. Am. And it will get agama, nakara. Now those things will come. Not required. Just know. Nam is there. Nam is preceded by padanta 2. Shan is a padam. How it is a padam and all? Out of scope. Don't worry about it now. Just know this example. Shan nakara at the end of the padam. And what nakara is? 2. Tavarga letter. So, now 2 letter, that is nakara, preceded by padanta 2. If you apply the exception number 2, stuttam must not happen. But here the word is nam. Therefore, we say it will happen. That is exception to exception. So, applying stutva vidhi, therefore, what do you get? Nakara. Dantya nakara will become murdhani nakara. Therefore, you get shannam. Shannam is shashti vibhakti bhaguvachanam of shat shabda. Shat shabda and all we have to learn. It's a long way to go. So, don't worry about it now. Shannam. Okay. Shannam iti. Then, similarly, shan plus navati. Navati is another word. Nakara preceded by murdhani nakara. That is the padanta tavarga letter nakara. Because navati, the very specific word is there, therefore stuttam will happen. Padan, this dantya nakara will be replaced by mudhani nakara, therefore you get shan navati 96. That is the meaning. Shan navati. Shan plus nagari becomes shan nagari. Okay, for these 3 words, this is an exception given. exception to exception. Other than this place, you apply Shtutva Vidhi. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, Guruji.
Yes.
Yes, Guruji.
So, Sharanji, if it is another word like Nabhi or something, I'm just making it up. So, how will it be, Sharanji?
That Shrutam will apply.
Okay.
If it is to be applied, it will apply.
Okay.
If it is specific Padanta too, it will not apply. I mean, that's what exception will apply. Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So, now we will see some example. I think this we have seen in the last class. Utsarga, where it applies, we have seen. Okay, so exceptions yes. only left out that I have taught you today. So you can remember the general rule what we saw. Now, all these are okay. Let's take this example. Shat plus Santaha. Shat plus Santaha. Shat is a padam. Shat means number 6. Santaha, beginning with Sakara. Sakara is in contact with Tavarga letter and it is at the end of the padam. Therefore, Shtuttam will not apply. More examples. Therefore, Shat plus Santaha will remain Shat Santaha only. Similarly, Shat Tarunaha, Takara, Tavarga letter, contact with Padanta Tavarga. Therefore, will not apply. Shtuttam will not apply. Similarly, Madulid. Madum lihati. Madulid means that which lick means to lick. Madum lihati means that which licks the honey. Plus dinaha. Then here you can see takara in contact with dakara. It's a padanta letter dakara. Padanta da, padanta varga letter. Therefore, shtuttam will not apply. Madulid dinaha. Okay. Now the summary. Summary is, we have seen exception. Exception only is important. If you know exception, that is fine. Now we will see some example. Examples, I think will come later. We'll do more examples. Examples will come later. We'll see many examples. Okay, so with this Shtutva Vidhi is over. With this, Shtutva Vidhi is completed. Okay. Summary is, Shtu in contact with the Shtu will be replaced by Shtu. That is the summary. And the exception is, if Shtu is preceded by Padanta Tu, then Shtuttam will not happen. And also, the first exception we saw, exception number 1, there it is, he said, when Shtu is followed by Shakara, then also Shtuttam will not happen. These are the 2 exceptions. And third exception is not a very serious exception. There Shtuttam will happen. Only for these 3 words. Naam, Navati, and Nagari. Okay. This is a summary. Then, I will introduce another rule today, a new rule. So with this, Shtutva is done. We will do more exercise. First, we have to understand the Vidhi, the rules very clearly. Then we will do exercise. Exercises are going to come. Okay, I'll give more words. We will do it, apply in the class itself. The class itself we will do. Now, and today another rule I will teach you. With that, I will stop. We are talking about the changes happening to Visarga, right? The changes happening to Visarga. Visarga is born and Visarga undergoes changes. The changes depending on what letter precedes and succeeds. When kar letter follows, we have seen Visarga is replaced by Sakara. All those things we know. When kar, what is kar? Kar letter means? What is kar?
Pratyaya Guruji.
Kar is heart consonant.
Heart consonant.
Pratyahara. Kar is a pratyahara, heart consonants. If you remove heart consonants from the letter, from the letters of the language, what is left out?
Soft consonants.
What is a pratyahara for soft consonants?
Hush.
Hush. That is what is given here. changes happening to Visarga when followed by Ash. What are the Ash letter? Ayun, Riluk, Aung, Ayouj, Ayavarat, Lan, Yamanga, Nanam, Jahai, Gadadash,
Jabba Gadadash.
Yes, up to Gadadash.
Yes, up to Gadadash. So it means it covers what? Ashpratyahara covers
soft consonants.
Vowels and soft consonants. That's what you have to say. All the vowels plus soft consonants. What about the last letter of the sibilant? Is it a soft consonant or hard consonant? Sha, sha, sa, ha, is it a soft consonant or
it's
hard
a consonant? It's a soft consonant.
Hi, in the pratyahara, you can see hayavarat, it is there. Soft consonant. Also, it is at the last sutra. Shashasar hal. There ha is there. Ha is the only letter repeated twice in the Mageshwara Sutra. Okay. Because it is a soft consonant, it has to be included there. That's why it is in the first place also. As a part of the sibilant, it is there at the end. And since it is a soft consonant, therefore it is at the beginning also. However, at beginning of the vowels. In the Mageshwara Sutra, you see, you understand, right? That's why it is repeated twice.
Yeah, it is also semi-vowel.
Not semi-vowel. It is along with the semi-vowel given, but it is not a semi-vowel. How can it be semi-vowel?
Because it is in the Sutra 5 where all of them are semi-vowels. Antastha.
All of them are semi-vowel, but this is not semi-vowel.
Not ha. Okay.
How can it be a semi-vowel? It's a sibilant. Ushmavarna. Now, when this follows, Ash letter follows. That is what we are going to discuss. When Ash letter follows, what happens to Visarga? So, don't confuse with Kar letter. Kar letter topic is over. Visarga followed by Kar is over. Now, Visarga followed by Ash. When Visarga is followed by Kar letter, we don't bother about what precedes Visarga. Understand what I'm saying? When Visarga is followed by Kar letter, that is hard consonants, we don't have to worry about what precedes Visarga. But here, when Hash letter follows, that is vowels or soft consonants follow Visarga, then you have to take into consideration what precedes Visarga. The preceding letter also important, becomes important. Important. Understand? Note this. So far we have not seen only what follows. In Shrutva, Shrutva also, Kar letter follows Isa. But here, we have to see what precedes. Okay. When Visarga is followed by Ash letter, Ash is equal to Ash plus Hash. Vowels and soft consonants. The letter preceding Visarga is also important. Depending on the preceding letter, the Visarga undergoes changes. The following letter is already Ash letter. So, the preceding letter also important. Depending on that, undergoes changes. What are the possibilities that is covered here? That is, Visarga can be preceded. You have to look from the standpoint of Visarga. What precedes Visarga? What succeeds Visarga? The first possibility. Visarga preceded by Akara, followed by Akara. Number one. Visarga preceded by Akara, followed by Hash soft consonants. Number two. Visarga preceded by Akara, followed by Ach. Why? Ach includes Akara also. That is why within bracket I have given, excepting A, because already covered. So it means other than what does it mean? Why I have mentioned like this? Can you think and answer why it is so? What is the difference between A and C? Because C already covers A. Then why it is required? Why A is required? I can just simply write C alone. A is not required. Can you say why it is? Think. Anybody?
The other vowels
Yes.
The other vowel as well, Sharanji.
I didn't get you.
Here it is.
It includes all vowels.
Yeah, all vowels. Like
so all vowels include akara also. Then why do we need that?
The change will be different for
akara only,
and different for akara other vowels.
Is there.
Very good. That is the question. That is the answer. That's what I want. When you say here a, it is only short vowel a. Whereas here h, when we say excepting a, because a is already covered, therefore this h includes akara onwards. Dirga akara doesn't include harasva akara. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, Guruji.
All
yes,
of
Guruji.
You.
Yes, Guruji.
That is why, given, instead of saying a, e, u, u, I'm just saying h, but within bracket I have given excepting harasva akara. That is covered as, that is why specifically given. First, you have to understand this. If you follow this, then only you will understand further. So, the third possibility, visarga preceded by a, followed by h. This h means excepting hrasva akara. Then, last one.
In the sense, then...
background noise is there.
In the sense it is hraswa and dirga, both will be included.
I didn't get you. Which one? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, in ach. Yeah.
Okay.
Ach includes, see, what is ach? Tell me. What is ach? Right?
Yes, G.
So, a means a stands for a. E means e. U is u. Both are there, rasva, dirga, right? For rasva akara already covered, that is number A. And here rasva akara not required here, because something will happen to visarga. That's why specifically number C is given as a different possibility. Why I am given a different possibility? Because a different adesha will come in the place of visarga. That is why it is given like that. So here in this H, you have to exclude rasva akara. Because rasva akara here it is the subset of C, that is A. That possibility, when it comes, a different adesha will come in the place of visarga. You will see. Okay, we'll understand.
So here ach, in ach it starts from a e like that.
Yes, exactly. Oh, that is what okay. It is. Yes. Okay. That is exactly, that is what it is. Yes. Then fourth possibility is visarga preceded by akara, dirga akara, and followed by ash. Why just four possibilities only are given? There are so many possibilities are there. In other possibilities, nothing will happen. Nothing will happen means that visarga, that no changes will happen to visarga. No changes will happen to visarga. That is why it is not given. We have to bother about only when changes happen. We need not bother about when changes don't happen, right? Therefore, it is not covered. So only the sandhi, for this sandhi, you have to know only this fourth possibility. Visarga preceded by a, followed by a. Visarga preceded by a, followed by ash. Visarga preceded by a, followed by ash. And visarga preceded by a and followed by ash letter. Only this fourth possibility. Other possibilities we don't have to worry, because no changes happen to visarga. Visarga itself will not be there. In fact, to say that we will see a bit later. So these are the four. So it's very simple. Other possibilities not there. That's why I'm saying very simple. Other possibilities means visarga preceded by e, visarga followed by e. All those things are not there, because nothing happens. So if for them, common thing is visarga will remain as it is. Or before visarga, what was there? That will continue. That is, repa will continue. That's what it means. Therefore, those possibilities are not covered. Not important, because there is no rule. There is no changes happening. That is, there is no adesha in the place of visarga. Therefore, not covered. Only this fourth possibility. Understand? If you ask why fourth possibility only, for that is the answer. Now, oh, last one also is okay. When Visarga is followed by ash letter, last one, last possibility, and preceded by any letter. Oh, the last possibility is what I already told. That's what I told actually now. The Visarga is followed by ash letter. Ash letter is vowels and soft consonants. And preceded by any letter other than what mentioned above. That is what covers all the possibilities. Then what happens? Then Repa has to be considered in the place of Visarga. Then you consider Visarga in the place of Visarga. What is there? Repa. From Repa only this Visarga has come. Right? From Repa only Visarga has come. In fact, Visarga will come only when certain conditions are fulfilled. Visarga will come only when certain conditions are fulfilled for the Repa. What are the conditions?
When Repa,
very good. Padanta Sakara, no, not Padanta. From that only Repa came. When Repa will become Visarga? My question is, when Repa will become Visarga? Padanta Sakara is the origin. We are not talking about that.
When it is followed by a car letter.
Very good. Followed by car letter or? Avasana. Stop.
Avasana. Yes.
Yes. See, Sakara. From Padanta Sakara, Ru Repa comes. That is different. My question is, was not that. How Visarga, when Visarga comes in the place of Repa? That was a question. So Visarga as an Adesha will come in the place of Repa. When Repa is followed by Kar letter or at the end, Avasana. Okay, remember that. Is it clear, Girjaji?
Yes, Guruji.
So, now here what happens? The fifth condition, that is not a rule, really. So, if none of the above, the first four, are covered, that is, Visarga followed by Ash and preceded by any letter other than what mentioned above, then what will happen? Then it is, Visarga itself is not the Repa alone was there and it continues. Right? Repa alone, it was there and continues. Otherwise, you can understand like this. In the place of Visarga, you have to consider Repa to be present. Okay. In the place of Visarga, you have to consider Repa to be present. In fact, Repa only is present. That is all you have to consider. If you don't understand, you can take it that way. Your choice. When we see examples, it will become more clear. All the four possibility. First, we'll see one by one. The first possibility, I'll explain and then we'll stop today's class. First possibility, for you to think. First possibility, you take 1 week time to think. Visarga preceded by A, followed by A. Then what happens to Visarga? Visarga, when followed and preceded by Akara, then it will be replaced by Ukara. It will be replaced by Ukara. Adesha is Ukara. Example, Ramaha plus Api. Here Visarga is there. Visarga is preceded by Akara, followed by
Akara.
Akara. So Visarga will be replaced by Ukara.
Ukara.
Now what will happen? Rama plus U plus Api.
Ramu.
A plus U. A plus U will become
Ramo.
Ramo plus Api. Akara plus Ukara. What Sandhi?
Gunasandhi.
Sandhi. Achandhi is important. Ramo. Ramo plus Api. Then, that's what I've written. Akara plus Ukara becomes Okara. Then Ramo plus Api you get. Then Ramo plus Api, what will happen after that? What is Ramo?
Purva Rupa Sandhi.
Okara. All Achandi rules you need to remember. Okara. O letter. Ang letter, right? Padanta Ang. Followed by the Padam. Beginning with Rasvakara. then the place of purva and para, purva will be the adesha. Purva rupa sandhi, this we have seen many times, so many classes we have spent on the achsandhi rules. You have to recollect what we have seen, 15 or 16 classes only on the achsandhi. Therefore, you have ramopi, form is ramopi. Ramaha plus api will become ramopi. All the other rules are achsandhi rules. Only here you have to remember, visarga is replaced by ukara. When preceded by a, followed by a. Similarly, another example. You understand this example?
Yes, Guruji.
Ramaha plus agachat. Visarga preceded by
akara.
Akara followed by akara. What will happen? Visarga will be replaced by u. The condition is fulfilled. So Ramo plus agachat. Ramo gachat. This is the form you get. Is this examples clear?
Yes, Guruji.
Yes. Okay. This is enough today. We'll stop here. More on this. I have to explain more on this. We'll see that in the next class. First, we have to understand this very clear. Two examples only I given. Yeah.
Yeah.
So further changes, we'll see. And please continue your Shabda memory session. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantih Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. When you have completed all the Sandhi, we can do the Sandhi Samskrita Bharati book as the whole exercise we will do once we complete all the Sandhi rules.
Okay. So
yes.
Dhaniwad.
Dhaniwad, Swamiji.
Yes, Dhaniwad.